Let's start. So what I was discussed, or we discussed yesterday in the last class, that we have five types of power stations: hydro power stations,
coal-fired,
nuclear power station, wind power station, coal-fired power station, and the last one is solar power station, which is solar energy. Right. So solar power station, all of us know that solar power station where the solar energy is converted to produce electricity. All right. So, but here one thing you have to understand, that conceptually there is a difference between solar panel and photovoltaic cell. In general language, we say that the collection of solar cells is called as a solar panel. But technically, there is a difference between solar panel and photovoltaic cell. Solar panel is also using solar energy. Photovoltaic cell is also using solar energy. Input energies are same, but output energies are different. So solar energy, where is only solar panel is only used for converting the solar energy to heat energy, to convert or for heating the water purpose. But photovoltaic cell, the name itself, photo means photon. Photon means light. So here the solar energy is converted to electricity, and photovoltaic cell is very much important than solar panel. And this is one more question, guarantee question in solar energy: difference between solar panel and photovoltaic cell. Okay, so solar panel, where solar energy converted to heat energy; photovoltaic cell, where the solar energy converted to electricity. And for information, photovoltaic cell, generally we use diodes. Can anybody tell me what is the construction of a diode?
There's a negative cell and a positive side.
Diksha is telling.
There's a negative side and a positive side, which limits the flow of from one side to another.
Yeah, see, diode may. What are the two components we have?
Holes and electrons.
Yeah, holes and electrons. But what is the part called? There are two types of semiconductors.
P-type and N-type semiconductor.
Exactly. Yeah. P-type semiconductor and N-type semiconductor. Right? So, P-type semiconductor is an anode, N-type semiconductor is a cathode. So, same P-N junction diode we use in the solar panel also to get the electricity. So, a basic structure of the solar panel I showed to you. You see here, sun rays are falling on the solar panel. Okay, the black body, and in below you have the water, which is the black body takes the heat from the solar rays, and the heat is heating the water. So I mentioned here that it absorbs sun rays, pass to the black body, then the black body absorbs more radiation, gets heated. So this is, you understand, simple understanding. Now coming to photovoltaic cell, see here, it converts solar energy to electrical energy, and it is having silicon plates. Why I mentioned silicon plates?
It's a semiconductor.
Exactly, it's a semiconductor. So if you see the simple structure of the solar photovoltaic cell, the silicon negative plate, silicon positive plate you have. The sun rays are falling on the top plate, which is negative plate. And you know that negative plate is nothing but consists of electrons, and these electrons are moving towards the, you know,
positive plate.
But how the electrons, you know, coming and moving from the positive plate means, you see the photons, it is just similar to a concept called photoelectric effect. We are going to discuss this photoelectric effect in the quantum physics. So photoelectric effect says that photons falls on the metal plate and electrons are released. For simple understanding, I'm telling you, photoelectric effect, which was explained by Einstein, he said that photons are light particles falling on the metal plate and electrons are released. In our context, how do we get photons? Tell me.
Light.
The sun rays?
The sun rays. Yeah. Exactly. Light or sun rays. So sun rays
consist
of, the sun rays consist of light. So that light consists of photons. So photons are falling on the metal plate. And here the metal plate is a negative plate. Silicon negative plate. Correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. The moment the photons falling on the negative plate, inside the plate you have electrons. And those electrons taking the photon energy and convert it to kinetic energy. The moment the photon energy converts to kinetic energy, electrons excited and they will move to the positive plate side. And that is how the electricity is generated. A small description is given to you. When sun rays falling on the negative plate, photons collide with silicon atoms. These atoms release electrons, leaving holes behind. These electrons produce electric energy. Same thing, right? So basically, when they ask you to write how the photovoltaic cell works, so this is the description you need to write. And also, if you want to add photoelectric effect, it is a valid information to us. We say that photoelectric effect where the photons falls on the metal plate and electrons are released. And here the photons are sun rays falling on the metal plate, means silicon negative plate. Then the electrons inside absorbs the photon energy and converts to kinetic energy, and electrons are moved from the plate, which produces the electricity. Understood?
Hmm.
Anyone have any doubt on this
one? Sir, one minute.
Yeah, one by one.
Yeah.
Lakshman?
Nothing.
Who is asking here?
So me.
Ah, Sudiksha. Yeah, tell me.
Yeah. So at the when the sunrise falls on the plate, the photon has some kinetic energy, which the
photons have. Listen. Photons have photon energy.
Okay. Right.
And this photon energy gained by the electrons.
Okay.
I mean, they absorb the photon energy. So therefore, the electrons taking the photon energy as kinetic energy.
Okay.
That is how electrons are in motion.
All right. Yeah.
So the photon energy is converted to kinetic energy by the electrons?
Exactly.
Okay. Okay.
That's why electrons are in motion, so it produces electricity. Yes. Any other doubt? Got it?
So the energy transfer would be photon energy to kinetic energy to electrical energy, right?
Yeah. Correct. All right. This is about the solar energy. This is enough for us. Okay. We don't have much information, but we have problem solving on solar energy in a different approach, mathematical approach. I will give one question later. Okay, so I think all of you have written. Now I'm going to show you a problem to you. Okay, and we have to do this problem in 5 minutes, because only this allows only for 40 minutes to us. 5 minutes you need to do. Keep your calculator, notebook with you. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so this is a problem. Able to see? Do I need to increase the size?
No, sir, it's good.
No, sir, it's okay.
Okay. So question says, a small island community requires a peak power of 850 kilowatts. Two systems are available for supplying the energy, wind power or photovoltaic cells. Outlined with reference to energy conversion in the machine, the main features of conventional horizontal axis wind generator. 3 marks, 3 minutes, do it. Three marks means at least you need to write three valid sentences. They're asking the features of a wind generator, windmill.
Oh, so they mean windmill in general. So that includes like the things and the turbine and
yes, the everything. Right? The blades connected to your tube, the tube connected to your big pole, everything. Anyone have finished answering the first question?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah. Monique, tell me what you have written.
So basically, the wind energy or the kinetic energy of the wind, of like air particles, they're converted into mechanical energy using a turbine that provides rotational motion to a generator,
yes,
which uses that rotational motion to turn it into electricity.
Wait a moment. Till rotational motion is perfect, once the rotation motion happening,
then okay, to move a coil across a magnetic, fixed magnetic field, causing an EMF to be generated.
Ah, exactly. Correct. So what you said is right. So the because of wind energy, the turbines rotate, and it which gives kinetic energy. And since the turbines are rotating, the turbines connected to a coil. So the coil is also rotating in the magnetic field, as you know, electromagnetic induction. The coil rotates in the magnetic field, and due to that, the coil rotation, the electricity is generated. Have written like this. So 3 marks for the first point, you need to mention that wind turbine blades are rotating. Second point, kinetic energy is converting. Wind energy converting into kinetic energy. Third point, the kinetic energy makes the coil to rotate in the magnetic field, which is producing electrical energy. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, next question. Do it 2 minutes. Mean wind speed of island is 8 meters per second. Show that the maximum power available of the generator of a blade length 45 meters is approximately 2 megawatts. So already answer is given to you. You have to show it.
So the blade thing is in, it's circular, right?
Circular.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, and the blade rotates, it creates a circle.
Yeah.
So what is the formula you have used?
Half P A V square.
Half rho A V cube, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Perfect.
It is 1.95 megawatt.
1.99 megawatts. Right answer?
95. Yeah.
Yeah, approximately 2 megawatts. 1.99 megawatts. I think all of you got it. Power equal to half rho A V cube. Now see the next question. The efficiency of generator is 24%. Did you
got
these generators? That would be required to provide the islanders with enough power to meet their energy requirements.
Sir, can you, in the second bit, I didn't get that answer. I got 2.4.
Maybe some...
It's half into 1.2 into 2025 pi into 512, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, 2000 into 500. Oh, it's 8. No, never mind. So I got it. I did. I took 8 squared. Yeah, yeah. Never mind. 1.95 into 10 to the power 6 watts. So, right.
I have squared.
Yeah.
Speed is how much? 8 squared. Okay, next question, answer you have got it?
Yeah, 1 second, sir.
Two generators, right? I think.
Sanjeev?
Because one generator, 24% efficiency, is producing 470 kilowatts.
Ah, exactly. Yes. Therefore, the answer is two generators.
Yes, sir.
Good. So, what here the... Sanjeev has done that 24% efficiency. So 24% of 1.9 megawatts you have taken, correct?
Yes.
Yes.
It's 1.86. So basically two of those.
Yes. So 24% which is 24 by 0.24 into the efficiency of 1.9 megawatts. If you take, that will give you, how much you got the answer, 24%?
470, sir.
470?
Wait, no, 45,000.
Yeah, 4,000.
456,000.
Yeah,
right?
470 megawatts?
Yes.
Kilowatt,
oh, yeah, yeah. Wait, 460.
No, wait, what? No, 0.4.
Either way, it will be two generators, right? It's fine.
Yeah.
So it's 470 kilowatts, sir.
It's not megawatts.
Kilowatts.
Kilowatts, sir. Kilowatts, not megawatts.
That's the mistake I have written. So it is 470 kilowatts. Obviously, in the beginning of the question, if you see, it mentioned that peak power of 850 kilowatts. So approximately 2 required.
Yeah. It's 1.8, so we should round it up, right?
Yeah, round it to 2. Yeah. Perfect. Good. Now let's move on to the next concept. The next concept is the black body radiation. Yeah, able to see?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, you can read also, correct? Yeah.
Yes.
After discussing of power stations, it is very, very important necessity to understand black body radiation. So why we are learning the black body? Scientists wanted to know how the stars are emitting the radiation. And in the radiation, how they are able to emit different wavelengths. For example, sun radiation, if you take, you have visible light, you have infrared radiation, you have ultraviolet light. So solar energy consists of three different wavelengths, and different stars are consist of different types of wavelengths. So how these stars are able to emit different wavelengths is a big question for the scientists long time ago. So they wanted to study the radiations emitted by the sun or the star, but it's very difficult to, any person has to go near to the star, it's impossible. And if you want to send any machine also, it is impossible to us, because very hot bodies these are. So that's why they wanted to find some alternative method, so that without going to the sun, they need to find the nature of the sun. And there comes the black body. So they observed that black body radiation, when it emits the radiation, it's just emitting the radiation similar to the sun. So to study the solar radiation, scientists have closer similar behavior, which is a black body. And black body means, you know, that any body, if you coat it with a black color, is called black body. The first statement is that black body is, what is meant by black body? Any body coated
body with that absorbs the radiation, basically.
Yeah, sorry.
It's a body that absorbs the radiation.
Yeah. That is actual next point I need to say. First thing is that any body, if you coat it with a black color, is a black body. Technically, we say that black body which absorbs all the radiations emits no radiation. That's why it looks in black color, isn't it? But here the very important thing is that though black body doesn't emit any radiation, but when you increase the temperature, at one point of time, black body emits the radiations also. That's why we say black body is a good absorber and good emitter also. And here our understanding is good emitter side, we wanted to study the black body radiation. Okay, now you see the types of radiations. Black body emits different types of wavelengths. The wavelengths of electromagnetic spectrum. As all of you know, this electromagnetic spectrum consists of many radiations. If you see here, radio waves, microwaves, IR waves, visible, UV, X-rays, gamma, and lambda, right? We start from longest wavelength radio, then we end up by the shortest wavelength gamma. And this order you have to remember. It is not in the data booklet for information. Order you have to remember. Radio, micro, IR, visible, UV, X-rays, and gamma rays. All right, but how to remember? I made an acronym here. Maybe it's a funny sentence. Don't think of the meaning of the sentence. You have to understand the order. RAM is very useful X guy. So in the RAM, RA is radio, M is micro, I is infrared, visible, very is visible, useful is UV, X means X-ray, G means gamma rays. Got it?
Can you repeat that?
Huh?
It's written there in the purple.
On the board, it was there.
Ram is very useful, like guy.
Okay, now you can make your own sentences, but keep in mind that the order should be there.
You can remember it as gay also, bro. It's fine.
I know.
Okay. All right. So that is how the line should be written, by keeping in mind that lambda is in decreasing order. Okay, we are taking the descending arc. All right. Right. So the question in the MCQ they may ask you, because this ordering is also important in waves chapter. Next year we're going to start. Also important in astrophysics. That's why this acronym is important for us. All right. So in this, the very important radiation is IR waves, infrared, which are also called heat waves.
Yeah.
Okay. Now let us move on to the black body. So I mentioned already to you.
Is this Max Planck's theory of black body radiation?
Yes. Yeah. Oh, sorry. Max Planck.
Max Planck's theory of black body radiation is there now.
Of course, Planck. Yeah. Yeah. Planck's black body radiation is also there, but we are not discussing that concept.
Okay.
We are just taking the introduction of black body and then going to Boltzmann laws.
Lakshman, don't take too much, bro. Okay, control yourself. Control the emotions.
Yeah. It's okay. See, so black body is a good absorber, and understand that at a high temperature is a good emitter. That point need to be noted. Next, here, as I mentioned that we are working on the black body emitting the radiation. So that's why we need to work with the two mathematical formulae. One is Stefan-Boltzmann law, and the second is Wien displacement law. Wien displacement law going to come a little later. See, Stefan-Boltzmann law. It says that amount of energy emitted per unit area, per unit time. So that is nothing but see the formula E by A by T. So E by T, energy by time, is nothing but power by area, P by A, is directly proportional to 4th power of absolute temperature. Absolute is nothing but Kelvin temperature. Right? So that's the statement. Amount of energy emitted per unit energy, unit time, or simply you can say that the amount of power per unit area is directly proportional to 4th power of Kelvin temperature. So P by A is proportional to T power 4. And to remove the proportionality, we use a constant called Stefan constant. This is there in the data booklet. 5.67 into 10 power minus 8. And remember the unit. Once they ask the fundamental unit also. 5.67 10 power minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin power 4 is there, right? So that is the SI unit. Watt per meter square Kelvin power 4. Sometimes in one exam they ask the fundamental unit of Stefan constant. So what you need to do, tell me.
Write down subject that and write them all in SI unit.
What is mean by writing the SI unit into fundamental units?
In terms of the 7 fundamental units.
Exactly. Yeah. 6 only we have. In terms of 6 fundamental units, that means watt per meter square Kelvin for right. But I'm asking to show in terms of kg, meter, second, ampere, Kelvin, those units. Okay, so the SI unit needs to be remembered. Okay, so Stefan constant's number is given to you. Now there's one more variable, emissivity. Very important factor in Stefan-Boltzmann law. Emissivity, the word itself tells you that it talks about the ability or the amount of percentage of emission power. How much of radiation is emitted depend on the emissivity E. So I mentioned here, emissivity decides the efficiency of emission of a body. And its maximum value is 1 only. 1 means 100%. 0 means 0%. That means 0 means it doesn't have emissivity power. That means the black body is an absorber. Isn't it? When I say E equal to 0, the emissivity is 0. That means there is no emission power. That means entire energy is absorbed. And the black body is a good absorber. If the emissivity is equal to 1, it's the best emitter. Because 100% emission is be shown. Okay. By default, in the problem solving, they will give you emissivity value to you. If they don't give you, you take it granted that E equal to 1. Okay? Right, guys, understanding?
Yes, sir.
Indeed. Right. So we have only 10 minutes left. I go a little bit faster. Now see. Power per unit area, it is also called intensity of radiation, right? So the formula can also be written as intensity equal sigma E T power 4. Isn't it?
Yeah.
P by A equal to sigma E T power 4. Instead of P by A, I have taken I. So I equal to sigma E T power 4. Now see the table here. Different emissivity values for the different substances. And you can identify that. Black body emissivity is 1. Means 100% efficiency. And which one have least efficiency?
Ice.
Ice. Remember, ice have least efficiency. That means it absorbs more. It absorbs more amount of intensity. Right. Now, this is another important formula for Stephen-Boltzmann law. What we are understanding here, emissivity tells that any body can emit. Any black body or partially black body also can emit some amount of radiation, but maybe little amount of radiation. For example, you see, you are right now, you are in the room. You are the, as a human body, you are emitting the heat radiations. You're emitting the heat radiations. Okay. And the walls of your room also emitting some amount of heat radiations. So if I ask you that, what is the amount of radiation, net amount of radiation emitted by the system of you and your room? That means what we do, we take amount of radiation by you, amount of radiation by the room, and we take the difference of it. Correct?
Mm, yeah.
You understand the logic behind that, what I said?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. Similarly, here also same thing mentioned here. You see, there is a black body, a circle. Inside the black body, there is another body which is emitting radiation. Okay. Now, radiation emitted by the body at the temperature capital T, the formula is given to you. As I mentioned, P by A equal to sigma E T power 4. A has taken to the right hand side. So, P1 equal to sigma A E T power 4. Now, radiation absorbed by the black body.
So, but won't the emissivity constants be different for both of them?
That emissivity constant, we will give in the problem because there is no perfect value for that. Based on the problem solving, we will give some values to you. You need to substitute it.
Okay.
No specific value for it. Okay. Of course, if you pure black body, I can say E equal to 1. But here, for theoretical understanding, I mentioned that both have the same emissivity values. That's why taking the E common. So,
and the realistically, they'll have different E values.
Body, yes, yes. What are you asking?
They'll have different E values, right, sir?
If they have different E values, then the formula will be changed here.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. I was saying this, assuming that both of them have the same emissivity.
Yeah, yeah. It's an assumption. In reality, in real, E values are different.
Yeah, obviously.
Yeah. So if you see the power difference, sigma A E T power 4 and minus T B power 4 is the formula. And now see here, I mentioned one more case study. If T equal T B, as you know that, if both the temperatures are same, then both the powers are equal, isn't it?
Yeah. Zero.
Because power is directly proportional to T power 4.
Yeah.
And as temperature equal, powers are also equal.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, so net energy, net power is zero.
Yes. Right? Net power is zero, powers are equal. So.
One second, sir. Can I just take this down?
Yeah, yeah. No, no, note it down. No problem. Just I'm checking.
Hello?
We have 5 minutes left. No problem. I can go.
Hello?
Sir, why do we have 5 minutes left only?
So we have 30 minutes.
We have to 3:20,
sir. Sorry, what you said? Can you loud please?
Sir, we have class till 3:20. No, why are there only 5 minutes left?
Because this Zoom is allows only 40 minutes class. Once again, I need to reactivate. See, when this video is got over now, don't go away. I again send a link to you.
Okay.
Understanding
classes on Hangouts. Meet,
so we can keep.
We can just have Hangouts call. No?
Yeah, Hangouts Meet, sir. You can do Hangouts.
I got it. Hangouts is somehow is not working with me. That's why I taken this. This is not a problem. See, once it's ended, I will give one more link to you. Just immediately connect it. We'll continue the class. Okay.
Okay, sir.
You put that link now only. Anyways, 5 minutes only are left. No, we can just put up that link.
Yeah.
Let's wait. Just take down these notes at least.
Take down the notes and solve this problem, guys. Meanwhile,
so one second.
So in 4 minutes of time, you will need to find the answer for this question.
Okay, sir.
By what factor obviously, is the power emitted?
200 to the power of 4 divided by 100 to the power of 4.
Good.
Is that right?
Do it. I'll
16, show. Sir.
Yeah, 16.
Body increase and the temperature increase.
T-power 4, na?
Yes, Sanjay.
See, temperature is in Kelvin.
16, guys,
huh? Temperature is in Kelvin. Don't do this mistake.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
270.
Oh, shit. Wrong.
Two point six. Let me check.
The 2.6, sir.
No,
Jill. Yeah, 2.5.
No, nine. I got that.
Hello, 2.39.
No, sir. It has to be the other way around. It has to be 4.73.
The temperature is increasing, right?
Yeah, exactly. So it has to be 2.59.
Divided by the body increase. Aha. Uh-huh. Okay, right. So what by
2.58? Yeah, 2.59.
2.59.
Yes.
Sachin stuff.
Okay, next question. Calculate the ratio of power radiated per unit area from two black bodies.
81.
Temperature
900
to
300.
Huh.
81.
81 times.
3 power.
81?
Yes. Yeah.
That's the right answer.
Hey, how are you guys doing this? Wait, I'm confused. What are you guys?
9 is 3 times 3. So 3 into 3.2.
Shivram, sir.
Uh-huh.
I have a doubt, sir. Uh-huh. Sir, in the exam, we get calculated for paper 1 and we get this also for paper 1, right? Even the
data is not allowed for paper 1.
Okay, data booklet?
Data booklets are allowed.
For sir, do we have exam?
Allowed for paper 2. And this type of problem, now it will be in the paper 2 only. But second problem is paper 1.
No. Sir, there's no data booklet for paper 1.
You have data booklets for paper 1, I'm telling you. Data booklet is allowed for all the papers.
Yeah, also, sir, do we have paper 3 this time?
No, you don't have. You have paper 1 and paper 2 only.
Okay, thanks, sir.
Yeah. According to SLHL, I have made the paper. Okay, no paper 3.
You're done making the paper, sir.
Almost.
Okay, you send for verification.
He's asking, huh?
You only make the paper or somebody else is making the paper?
Who else, sir? Sachin.
Sachin.
Shivram, sir.
Uh-huh.
Sir, send the paper to us. No, sir, we'll check it one last time.
Sir, just send it as a worksheet, sir. We'll get practice.
No, I will take last for the question paper also. All right. Okay, I think it is ending up. So don't go out of the class. I will send one other link to you. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Sure, sir. Sure. 3, 2, 1.